Hello, good evening to one and all. A warm welcome to all you lovely people. This is your Vijayalakshmi Subbaraman, the first woman grandmaster of India and an Arjuna awardee here, and we are on the seventh part of the great games of our greatest legends. Yes, we did start from 1400s and now we are in 1834. It's quite some time ago. Yes, I agree, but then you know, we have some great games. And we are starting our journey with the first unofficial world championship between, yes, Louis Charles Mahidela Bordonai and Alexander Macdonald. Bordonai, the French aristocrat who was completely penniless by the time he died, and Alexander Macdonald, the rich Irish businessman. Yes, the match was between these two legends, and they played a series of six matches comprising of 85 games. 85 games, you know, 85 match games in a span of just from, you know, almost 3 to 4 months, from June to October is what they played these matches in. And the first match was won by Louis Charles Le Bourdonnais, and the second match was won by Alexander Macdonald. So the thing is here, if you had seen in the first match, Bourdonnais won with a very convincing margin of 18-7. You know, they played a 25 game in the first match, and in London, and he won with a great margin of 18-7. And in the second match, it was a very close call. They played a 9-match series in which Macdonald finished with 5-4. He won the 9th game to clinch the second match at 5-4. And now we are into the third match, and in the third match we saw that yesterday La Bourdonnais had won. And in fact, at one point he was leading 5.5 to 2.5, and 5.5 to 2.5 is a huge margin. By the end of the 8th round, he was leading with a huge margin, 3-point lead. And you know what? Macdonald won the next 3 games consecutively, guys. 9, 10, 11, he won. So we are going to be seeing one of his games that he played against Bourdonnais. This was the match number 11. In the 11th match, Macdonald Alexander played a beautiful game in a Queen's Gambit accepted variation and won the game very convincingly in a variation that he had tried in the 9th round as well. And they played a total of 5 Queen's Gambit accepted in this third match in London, guys, in 1834. And out of which, Bourdonnais won the first 3 matches. That helped him in his lead. But Macdonald was able to get back by winning 2 of the last 4 games in this variation. And you will see what a beautiful game he has played, guys. D4, E5, C4, Dc4. E3, E5, Bishop C4, ED4. Of course, not the most famous variation. Nevertheless, it's a variation that was played quite often at that point of time. So, okay. Just give me a second. Okay, so here knight c3, and bishop d6. Here, of course, he had played bishop e7 in the previous matches, you know, previous games, and he lost miserably. So he had found a new improvement with bishop d6, and this did help him quite a bit, guys. After knight f3, knight c6. Again, he played one more move, castles here, which was again he lost, you know, eventually in that variation as well. So he went ahead with a beautiful improvement here. With, you know, there were two games that were played with castles here, and in one of the variations he goes ahead with h3, rook e8 check, bishop e3, and here MacDonald had played both knight c6 and bishop f4 here, guys. Knight c6 and bishop f4. Unfortunately, this bishop f4, although looking at it, you know, it looks like very attractive, but unfortunately this move doesn't suffice at all, guys. This move doesn't suffice at all. After playing bishop f4, he lost very quickly against Le Bourdonnais, and he went ahead with a further improvement in match 9 and played knight c6. After knight c6, you know, I will just show a couple of moves. Castles h6, a3, bishop f5, g4, bishop g4. Hg4, knight g4. This was a variation that was played in game number 9. Why am I showing this? Well, you will know very soon. So here he plays knight c6 in the 11th round match. And what does Le Bourdonnais? He is playing unassumingly. Okay, let me play castles. But after castles, h3, h6, a3, bishop f5. Very similar position to what we had in the previous game. Very similar position, guys. And here after g4, knight into g4, h into g4, bishop into g4. The only difference is in the previous position he played bishop into g4, h into g4, knight into g4, and he still won that game. Here he goes for the knight into g4, h into g4, bishop into g4, going ahead with this beautiful pin. And see how brilliantly MacDonald plays in this game, guys. After bishop e2, he has a very concrete plan in this position, guys. If you want, you know, maybe later on you can give it a 5-second pause and then look at it and then check out what could be the idea here. Or maybe I'll give a 5-second break here, guys. Check it out. Let me know what can be played. And I didn't get any hellos or good evenings or anything of that sort today. Well, better. If I received some messages, I would have been happy. But I will be more happy if you can suggest a move here, guys. Any suggestions, guys? Am I audible enough? I guess I should be. Because I'm almost screaming. Well, it's okay. So I'm going to be showing the move that was played here, and I really liked this move, guys, because after this move, actually white's position starts to crumble and black has a very concrete idea in this position. Bishop into f3. Yes, it is bishop into f3. He is giving this beautiful bishop. For what? Yes, he gets to play queen h4 here, and suddenly there is a lot of pressure on white, guys. Yes, Bhanupriya, can you suggest a move here? So rook e1 was played with the idea to play for queen h2 check with king f1, but after knight into d4, the position looks so yummy for white. For white? No, for black. After this, bishop h2 check, and suddenly you understand the idea of why it becomes so strong for black, guys, because you will be able to see that all of black's pieces are active. After rook d8, here in this position, you can see although black is one piece down, black has all the initiative in the world. He has all the compensation in the world. Yes. So bishop e3, knight f5, going for the discovered attack. Yes, going for the discovered attack, guys. After queen c2, queen h3 check, bishop g2 is the only move. And after queen g4, f3, queen g6. Again, what is the idea, guys? The idea here is to play knight g3 check, because there is a pin. A prophylactic pin is very much evident in this position, but then yes, it is not visible for the naked eye. So you need to be on the lookout for such kind of threats and pains, guys. So after bishop f2, knight e7, I mean, like, who would ever think of taking the knight back in this position, guys? And that's exactly why this game was, I felt, was one of the best games that McDonald had played, because after this knight e7, the idea is very, very clear once he plays knight e7. But initially, you will be thinking here, acha, what do I do here? Abhi kya karun? Kaun sa piece aage le jaun? But here, McDonald takes a break, thinks back, he sees what needs to be done, where should be the pieces be placed, and he goes for the perfect square for the knight. That is how he wished his knight was here. Right? Can he move? No, he can't move. So what does he do? He goes at the cost of two moves. Rook e1, knight d5. And suddenly now this has become a reality, guys. This has become a reality. Yes. So bishop c5. Again, a very nice move here that was played by McDonald was queen c6. You know, these kind of pins are very nagging and irritating for the opponent. And what does he do? The only move is to play. Where does he play? He has to either play queen f2 or queen b3. Queen f2 looks so, what to say, it's not in the spirit of the position. So yes, queen b3 has been played. The idea is on f5, he wants to play knight c3. Again, a prophylactic pin in hand, guys. Like, what an amazing prophylactic pin throughout the game by both the players. So here on queen b3, he plays knight f4, because McDonald is not interested about getting the piece back. He is more interested on this guy. So after bishop in f8, what does he play, guys? A beautiful move. Queen a6. This geometry of, you know, from here to here and here to here and from here to here. It's like a beautiful acute angle, right? Like, we are learning a lot of geometry and mathematics today, guys. But what do I say? That's what these guys are, you know. They teach us so many things. After king f2, rook onto d1. What happens on rook onto d1? On rook onto d1, queen e2 is a checkmate. Yes, it is a checkmate. So what does he play, guys? He plays bishop f1. And again, another tactic, guys. Bishop g1. Yes. The idea is very simple. On king into g1, I take rook into e1 and it again, another pin. So what does he do? How will he defend? Of course, by playing knight d2. So what do I do, guys, now? What do I do? Yes, 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 yes. Queen e2. I mean, the whole game throughout, from, I think, move number 12. Let's say move number 12, wherein he played this h3, bishop into g4. From this pin onwards till this move, I mean, like, for the last 18 odd moves, it was always a pin of this sort or that sort. Here a pin, there a pin, everywhere a pin. Yes? And that's how this game was won by McDonald. And guess what, guys? He equalized the score at 5.5, 5.5. He was trailing at 2.5 to 5.5. And he won 3 games in a row. 9, 10, 11 with the previous brilliant game again. But since there is a paucity of time, I'm not showing that game. But this game was even more brilliant, guys, because of these kind of amazing pins. Now, McDonald has tied with Lebedonoi at 5.5, 5.5. And now let's see what happens, guys. Ab dekhenge kya hoga. This is the final match. This is the final match of the third match that was held in London in 1834. And Here, MacDonnell is white and Labour Donoy is black. And guess what, guys? You know, it is always, as far as, because when I saw these matches, I always felt only one thing. There is this very famous saying that black is okay. You know, it was a very famous sentence back in the 80s. Go check it out, guys, and you will know why black is okay. With black pieces, a lot of wins was acquired, and they said that, you know, a lot of variations with black was considered to be really good. Check it out and let me know the exact thing as to who said it. I'm not going to give a clue on that. So this is the game between MacDonnell Alexander and Louis Charles Mahe de la Bourdonnais. And this is match number 3, game number 12, the final game of the third match. And as far as the match status is concerned, first match was won by Labour Donoy and the second match is won by MacDonnell. They are at 1 each. So let's see this game. This game is extremely crucial for both the players to see who is going to go ahead. Yes, after E f4, Bishop c4, Queen h4 check. Of course, this was a variation that was played quite often at that point of time. And g5, Knight c3, Bishop g7. Labour Donoy had lost a couple of games in this variation as well, but then this was a different game. Knight d5, yes, both of these players didn't believe in castles in this game. And they are going for, you know, it looks like both of them are moving on the opposite directions. King f1, King d8. So Bishop e2, Knight f6, Knight f6, Bishop into f6 and e5. E5, I'm not too sure, because here I think he would have done much better to just develop his pieces. But what do I say? After E5, Bishop E7, he cannot take D into E5, guys, because after D into E5, the disco check comes into 4 and white gets a piece. So on E5, he plays Bishop E7, Queen D3, Knight C6, C3, Bishop D7. And if you see, black is concentrating on developing and white is just pushing his pawns. E5, C3 and now G3. Very strange. But then how else will you lose, guys? So Queen H6 is being played. E into D6, Bishop into D6. And here you can see already white is having a lot of problems and black is already very well developed. After H4, G4 is being played. And now the threats are becoming real, guys. After Bishop d1, Queen f6. Again, disco check. King e1. After King e1, oh my god. Now you can see the evident weaknesses. That's why he should never have played e5 in the first place. Pawn on e4 was so nice. e4, d4. But then what do we say? After Queen e7 check, King f2, Rook e8. Suddenly there is a mating threat, guys. G into f4 was played, Queen e1, it's not yet over. So here, in fact, I felt very strange when he played Queen e4. But guess what, guys, he had some very beautiful ideas. Let's see what he does here. Queen e4, Bishop e4, Bishop h7, Bishop e6. It's very simple that Labour Donoy understood that his development is far superior than his opponent's, and he was playing for that. And see the way he does that. Bishop d5, Rook h2, Rook e1. And the last rope pin. Knight e2. Development advantage, guys. It's just development advantage. It's not, you know, development advantage is not something which comes only in the opening. It can be even in middle game, even in end game, as is evident from this game, guys. d5. So Knight e7. Knight d4, Knight into d5. And slowly the pawns start to fall. h5, Rook g1 check, King f2, Rook f1 check, King g3. See how beautifully he is playing. The same position was available 2 moves ago with the rook on even, and he has brought the rook to f1. I mean, like, it is something like very similar to the last game, guys, where MacDonnell had his knight on f5 and he wanted to bring it to f4. And he did that. And here in the same way, he had his rook on e1. He wanted to bring it to f1 and he has done that. All with, this was of course with the help of intermezzos. But okay, the previous game is slightly different. different, but then I'm just talking about the ideas, guys. So knight f4, king into g4, king d7, and you can see the, oh my god, what will happen to this king, guys? It's really sad. Bishop e6 check, knight d6. You must be wondering, how is white gonna win in the, black gonna win in this position? But you just see, rook e2, rook h8, bishop e4, and suddenly the king is starting to feel very uncomfortable. Yes, hello Aryan, you are back. King h4, bishop e7 check, king h3 was played. What do we do now? Sorry, Aryan, I didn't get your chat. You haven't replied to my chat. I'm just seeing that you have said hello. Right? Okay. So here, what happens is, guys, you can see that. So sad. I feel so sad for McDonald, guys. I can imagine the kind of plight he must have gone through at this point of time. So bishop d6. h6, he's still so unassuming. He's telling TK, let me at least pawn my queen kar deta hu. But then unfortunately he misses this small trap. Rook into c1, h7, rook into c3, intermezzo check. Here in case of rook into, there is a check. Where do I go, guys? I can't go here because then this check and I will lose this rook as well. I would lose this rook as well. Oh my god. I think my mouse is slipping. Yes, I'm able to see your chat, Aryan. I saw that you have said that hello, ma'am. Okay, so h7 was played. Rook into c3 check. Yes, I was about to tell knight f4, then king here. Should I go ahead and take the rook, guys? Should I go ahead and take the rook? No, I shouldn't. I should go for the checkmate. Such beauty, such beauty. Three pieces. Combination of three pieces. Yes, yes, yes. Amazing. Amazing. That's what I would say. So on rook into c7, h7 was played, rook into c3 check, king h4, bishop e7 check, king h5, and yes, they are reaching me, Aryan, absolutely they are reaching me. So on rook h3, Shaknath, and guess what, guys, guess what? Le Bourdonnais, Louis Charles Mahe de la Bourdonnais was able to clinch the third match. He won the third match. And he is now leading 2-1 on this match series. And we will be seeing more of these games tomorrow, guys. The fourth match was very crucial for these two people. And it was considered to be one of the most famous ones, and there's a very famous game in that which we will see tomorrow, guys. So that's about it from me, guys. Yes, yes, you can take the rook, but why should take the rook? You should go for the checkmate, right? Yes, yes, he won the third match. Now McDonald is leading 2-1. Sorry, Le Bourdonnais is leading 2-1. Slip off my tongue. I think I'm so tired today, right, guys? Anyway, so I will see you tomorrow at 9. This is your Vijay Lakshmi Subbaraman signing off. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye. Good night. And take care. And Jai Hind.